गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर भोली। एट लास्ट एन ऑफर केम फ्रॉम अ वेल टू डू ब्राइड ग्रूम फॉर भोली। ही हैड अ बिग शॉप, अ हाउस ऑफ हिज ओन एंड सेवरल थाउजेंड्स इन बैंक। ही वॉज नॉट आस्किंग फॉर डॉरी। The bridegroom was almost the age of Bholi's father and he also limped. The children from his first wife were quite grown up. These things did not matter to Bholi's parents. They were happy that she was at least going to be married. Bishambarnath, the bridegroom of Bholi, was a prosperous grocer. He came with a big party of friends and relatives. A brass band was playing a popular filmy tune. Ramlal was overjoyed to see such a pomp and splendor. Bholi's elder sisters were jealous of her luck. So now we will continue our chapter. When the auspicious moment came, the priest said, "Bring the bride." Bholi, clad in a red silken bridal dress, was led to the bride's place near the sacred fire. Now garland the bride, one of his friends prompted Bishambarnath. The bridegroom lifted the garland of yellow marigolds. Now the auspicious moment came and the priest said to bring the bride. The priest asked to bring the bride, Bholi. She was clad in a red silken bridal dress. She was led to the bride's place. And where was the place? The place was near the sacred fire. Garland the bride, one of his friends prompted Bishambarnath. The bridegroom lifted the garland of yellow marigolds. Now the bridegroom lifted the garland of yellow marigolds. A woman slipped back the silken veil from the bride's face. Bishambar took a quick glance. The garland remained poised in his hands. The bride slowly pulled down the veil over her face. What happened suddenly? A woman, she slipped back the silken veil from her face. Bishambar, he took a quick glance and the garland remained poised in his hands. He cried, "What happened? Have you seen her?" said Bishambar to the friend next to him. "She has pock marks on her face," he cried. "Have you seen? She has pock marks on her face." "So what? You are not young either." "Maybe, but if I am to marry her, her father must give me 5,000 rupees. Now, his friend, he said, "So what? You are not young either." But he replied, "Maybe, but if I am to marry her, her father must give me 5,000 rupees as dowry." Ramlal went and placed his turban, his honor, at Bishambar's feet. Do not humiliate me so. Take 2,000 rupees." Now Ramlal, he went to him and he placed his turban. He requested him. He put his turban at his feet. He said, "Do not humiliate me so. Please take 2,000 rupees. No, 5,000. Or we go back, keep your daughter." But he said, "No, give me 5,000 or I will go back, keep your daughter. Be a little considerate, please. If you go back, I can never show my face in the village. Boli's father, he requested again and again. He said, please, be a little considerate. If you go back, I can never show my face in the village. Then out with 5,000, he said, then give me 5,000. Tears streaming down his face. Ramlal went in, opened the safe and counted out the notes. He placed the bundle at the bridegroom's feet. Now the father was weeping. He went inside. He opened the safe and counted the notes and he placed the bundle at the bridegroom's feet. We will continue our chapter by tomorrow.